going to rule the world of two types. One, either you must be a contemporary or at least you must be a follower. The two, especially the self-reliant status of India, I want to say one thing. India must not be the follower of West at all. Getting everything from the West or getting inspiration from West is not required. Now we have a lot of people. We must create an inspiration to the West. I want the scientific community to develop first as an elementary level. Let them become scientists later. An idea of nanotechnology which all fields I have explained now, that must be established by a nano fans club, nano science club, nano students club, with materials available through net sources and international journal publications are there, directory of open access journals is there, and a lot of other prototype models are also available on demand and request. We have to develop that area, and most of the people taking the engineering are taking physics or chemistry. I kindly request, at least this is the Sikh community at the time of distress, they contributed at least a son from my family regarding the nation. To safeguard the scientific prestige and the dignity of our nation in the global scenario, at least we must be in parallel in speed in the race with the Western community in science, even though not as a pioneer or forerunner. For that, I want each and every student community based galaxy to donate at least one student for nanoscience, nanophysics, nanomedicine, etc., and which is going to clearly result us to get our country one more having the opportunity, once more being rethroned in the successful throne of global leadership and universal torch bearership. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.
Just in case.
Anything.
Any question, any doubt, one or two people.
Can you suggest a book which use the fundamentals of the of technology, sir?
Yeah.
Any book you want?
Is a book, sir?
Book. Now?
No.
Yeah, there are a lot of journals. Lot of books are there. The era of nanotechnology that gives the fundamental idea. The era of nanotechnology by Erich Drexler. IIT Roorkee they are having, IIT Delhi they are having, and Amity Institute they are having a school for nanotechnology. There are three major schools in there. There are lot of nanotechnology oriented companies. Dabur Pharma they are having one nanotechnology division for nanotechnology.
Anyone would like to say anything, especially people who have come from outside? Please, please, please.
In the recent past, some reports have appeared in the United States which indicate that the nanoparticles are very dangerous for human life if they are overused, because these particles are so small that they penetrate the skin. And we have some materials which are banned now because of this condition, like asbestos is one of them. Barium is one of them. Beryllium is one of them. They are all highly toxic and also carcinogenic. Now are we trying to develop another particle, nano-based particles, which may have very desirable mechanical and electrical and other thermal properties, but are they harmful to the human life? Again, we end up in another type of thing, we discover something, invent something here, which in the long run, if we overuse, may destroy the human life. What is your idea about that?
And this subject comes under the study of the control methodologies and risk factors of nanotechnology. All technologies, you must understand, there are three divisions. First, all technologies, they are having their own risks, even with electricity, even with fire, whatever may be the energy, they have their own implication. The implied dangers are also there, productivity is also there. And number two, depending upon utility, if the users, they are misdirecting it, they are getting into hazards, number two. Number third thing is very, very great thing in which your thing falls, that is improper understanding or insufficient understanding of a material, whether it could suit all. So everything must be understood at a long run base. That's what I told. Whenever you see a thing at an equi-optical status, you can see only the impending benefits. The impending benefits are interim immediate benefits. Long term run cannot be got in the other things except insight, which is possible only by a person's subjection or by means of any other paranatural thing. So genetically modified crops, they have come. So initially that cotton which has been produced, that created a craze among the people, and everybody modified, cultivated and used that. That created a very great loss of lives also. Their agricultural system was totally eroded. Like that, because of lack of proper understanding, misuse of things, then improper understanding and insufficient understanding of things. See, everything must be time tested. Time tested, person tested and place tested. If something is used here, the same conduciveness, whether it can be adapted to all places or not, number one. Number two, if something is to a particular person, whether it is universally adaptable and assimilable by all people or not, if something is appearing to be beneficial now, does it have any impact over a long period of run? Either immediately, mediately, or remotely, or genetically, whatever may be the impact, whether it may permeate to the other masses, or it may permeate to the genetic sequential lineage, it may be there. That long-term pursuit is not there in science. And I want to say in nanotechnology, all nanoparticles is, you know, that our body constitute of pores. Pores. Pore is there to vaporize the body heat as well as to imbibe the essentials from outside. So it is a semi-permeable membrane when it is a physiosmotic process. And these pores, you know, that they are wider. It is like the India International Convention Center for Nanoparticles. The small pore, it is like the conventional center auditorium. Very rightly you are told, it can easily penetrate and come outside. And anyhow, all metals, God has created a natural filter in xylem and phloem vessels. Xylem and phloem vessels of the plants, they absorb the particles with the malabhaga, mishabhaga, dhonabhaga. The trivial portions, the binamic portions and the wastages, they are filtered by the plants. And the same titanium, uranium, iron, calcium and whatever that you consume, if it is from a vegetative origination, that is very salubrious to us. And direct absorption at any cost, any science, except the science of contentment, peace and harmony without much of this expansion. See, that term we used to say, you are simple life theory. The theory in science is known as simple life theory. They are pessimists of technology. Pessimists of technology, they have made one theory known as simple life theory. You sharp of computer and brain, I told that any person being preoccupied with a computer more than a specific time, he will lose his human values and he'll be a machine in disguise. Affection, love, patriotism, benevolence, amicability, forgivingness, understanding, everything he will lose. For that, I don't want them to lose the communication system. Let it develop. At least 1 or 2 hours, they must think that they are human beings and having human relations. Loss of hair, insomnia, hyperacidity, irritation, fiendishness of your face, and looking yourself as an alien for yourself in mirror, not maintaining relations with the society, the domestic community, everything will happen. You can see last of the few decades, we are seeing lot of IITians and IT persons, as if they are coming out of the den after 1,000 or 2,000 years. some cave from the deep African forest they will look like. So according to simple life theory, you are given a reasonable life, a life of reasonable pleasure, happiness and prosperity. If you extend anything, you have to sacrifice some other greater valuable thing, either longevity, either your salubrity, wife's relation, kid's relation, your genetic lineage, everything is there. You have to unavoidably sacrifice these things. These things are understood only by ethical perceptions. Persons who are interested in immediate money minting industry, getting richness and US settlement, getting flats and cars, and going with the Western community in their richness and opulential status and ostentatious behaviors, for those people, this ethical inculcation that will not work out. Their brains are sealed and no advice will get inside. Whatever you are told is correct. But I can advise, or the science community can advise, that dealing with computers, number one, the dealing with energy, the dealing with heavy craft engines and industrial developments, it can be used. And anything with the sentient imbibition, that is immediately going to give you genetic loss or characteristic loss or humanitarian value loss. Yeah, they wanted to ask just only one question. And then I am going to leave. He means both of us?
No, the society or any person interested can be reach God or perceive God through nanotechnology.
See, God is the substratum of knowledge and power. God is the substratum of inexhaustible knowledge and power. And he is also the personification of the utmost subtlety. Nanoparticle is also certain that it has immense power inside. So through God we can understand nanotechnology. Either this nanotechnology means subtlety. Nanotechnology exists in everything. Even understanding our own sukshma, self-understanding is there. I have already told about two things. One is life technology, how to love others and how to live. So having all gadgets of life without knowing how to live, it is just like a dog playing with a pomegranate or something else. It cannot eat.